हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम सुधा मल्होत्रा, पीजीटी केमिस्ट्री, केंद्रीय विद्यालय आईटीबीपी देहरादून। वी विल बिगिन विद द हैलोजन फैमिली ग्रुप 17 ऑफ पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स। द हैलोजन फैमिली कंप्राइसेस ऑफ फ्लोरीन, क्लोरीन, ब्रोमीन, आयोडीन एंड एस्टाटाइन। द जनरल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन of these elements is NH2NP5. Fluorine and chlorine are fairly abundant, while bromine and iodine are less. And fluorine is mainly and present as insoluble fluoride in the form of fluorspar, cryolite or fluorapatite. Small quantities are also present in soil, river, water, plants and bones and teeth of animals. See, water contains chlorides, bromides and iodides of sodium, potassium, magnesium and calcium. The general electronic configuration of fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine is shown here, and you see here they have the 7 valence electrons. When we talk about the oxidation state, all the halogens exhibit -1 oxidation state. However, chlorine, bromine and iodine exhibit +1, +3, +5 and +7 oxidation states also. The readily acceptance of an electron is the reason for the strong oxidizing nature of halogens. See, they are very electronegative, so they have the tendency to accept the electrons, and that is why they are electronegative in nature. They are strong oxidizing nature. Fluorine is the strongest oxidizing halogens and oxidizes other halide ions in solution or even in the solid phase. In general, a halogen oxidizes halide ions of higher atomic number as depicted in the given chemical equation. These halogens, they react with metals to form metal halides. And the ionic character of these halides decreases in the order as given, as MF is greater than MCl, is greater than MBr, is greater than Mi. These halogens, they react with hydrogen to give hydrogen halides. But the affinity for hydrogen decreases from fluorine to iodine. Hydrogen halides dissolve in water to form hydrohalic acids. Halogens form many oxides with oxygen, but most of them are unstable. Fluorine forms two oxides, OF2 and O2F2. However, only OF2 is thermally stable. I have told you earlier that the compounds of oxygen and fluorine are called fluorides. They are not called oxides because fluorine is more electronegative and it's placed on the right hand side. These oxides are essentially oxygen fluorides because of the high electronegativity of fluorine than oxygen. Both are strong fluorinating agents. Chlorine, bromine, iodine form oxides in which the oxidation state of these halogens range from +1 to +7. Chlorine oxides are highly reactive oxidizing agents and tend to explode. ClO2 is used as a bleaching agent for paper, pulp and textiles and in water treatment. The bromine oxides are the least stable halogen oxides and exist only at low temperature. They are very powerful oxidizing agents. The iodine oxides are insoluble solids and decompose on heating. The reactivity of halogens towards other halogens is a matter of great interest. Why? Because these halogens combine with themselves to form a number of interhalogen compounds with the general formula given here, where X is larger size halogen and X dash is a smaller size halogen. Fluorine is anomalous in many properties. Ionization enthalpy, electronegativity, electrode potentials are all higher for fluorine than expected from the trend set by other halogens. also ionic and covalent radii, melting and boiling point, enthalpy of bond dissociation and electron gain enthalpy are quite lower than expected. The anomalous behavior of fluorine is due to its small size, high electronegativity, low fluorine-fluorine bond dissociation enthalpy and non-availability of d orbitals in valence shell. Most of the reactions of fluorine are exothermic due to small size and strong bond formed by it with other elements. It forms only one oxoacids, while other halogens form a number of oxoacids. When we talk about chlorine, it was discovered by Scheele by the action of HCl on MnO2. We do this reaction in the lab also. Davy, however, established its elementary nature and suggested the name chlorine on account of its color. Chloros means greenish yellow in color. And how is chlorine prepared? It's prepared in the laboratory when you heat manganese dioxide with concentrated HCl. And by the action of HCl on potassium permanganate, we have done the reaction in practicals in class 11th. You have done MnO2 and HCl. And chlorine is manufactured by Deacon's process, by oxidation of hydrogen chloride gas, by atmospheric oxygen in the presence of CuCl2. It's also prepared by electrolytic process, by electrolysis of brine. It's liberated at anode. And it's also obtained as a byproduct in many chemical industries. When we talk about the properties of chlorine, it's a greenish yellow gas with a pungent and suffocating odor. It's about 2 to 5 times heavier than air. It can be liquefied easily into greenish yellow liquid, which boils at 298 Kelvin, and it's soluble in water. Chlorine reacts with a number of metals and non-metals to form chlorides, as shown here. And it has a great affinity for hydrogen and reacts to form HCl. It also reacts with H2S to form HCl and liberate out sulfur. Ammonia reacts with chlorine to form ammonium chloride, and if excess of chlorine is used, we get NCl3 and HCl. With cold and dilute alkaline, chlorine produces a mixture of chloride and hypochlorite, but with hot and concentrated alkalis, it gives chloride and chlorate, as shown in the chemical reactions here. With dry slaked lime, it gives bleaching powder, calcium oxochloride. These are very important reactions of halogens usually asked in the examination. It oxidizes ferrous to ferric, sulfide to sulfate, and sulfur dioxide to sulfuric acid and iodine to iodic acid. So students, here are the reactions shown given here. And it's used as a bleaching wood pulp required for the manufacture of paper and rayon, in the extraction of gold and platinum, in the manufacture of dyes, in sterilizing drinking water and preparation of poisonous gases such as phosgene and tear gas. HCl, hydrochloric acid, is prepared, Glauber prepared this acid in 1648 by heating common salt with concentrated sulfuric acid. And in the laboratory, it's prepared by heating sodium chloride with concentrated sulfuric acid. The properties of HCl, when we talk about, it's colorless, pungent smelling gas, easily liquefied to colorless liquid, extremely soluble in water, and reacts with ammonia to give white fumes of ammonium chloride. In the laboratory also, we do this practical. White fumes comes out when you bring a glass rod dipped in HCl near the mouth of the test tube. When 3 parts of concentrated HCl and 1 part of concentrated HNO3 are mixed together, we get aqua regia, which is used for dissolving noble metals, as given in these equations here. Hydrochloric acid decomposes salts of weaker acids, for example, carbonates, hydrogen carbonates, sulfides, etc. And HCl is used in the manufacture of chlorine, ammonium chloride, glucose, for extracting glue from bones and purifying bone black. It's used in medicine as a laboratory reagent. When we talk about interhalogen compounds, when 2 different halogens react with each other, interhalogen compounds are formed. They can be assigned general composition as XX-XX-3X-5 and so on, where X is a halogen of larger size and X-dash of smaller size, and X-dash is more electropositive than X. How are these interhalogen compounds prepared? By direct combination or by the action of halogen on lower interhalogen compounds. So these are all covalent molecules, diamagnetic in nature, volatile solids. Their physical properties are intermediate between constituent halogens, though their melting point and boiling point are a bit higher than expected. In general, interhalogen compounds are more reactive than halogens. Very important point. Why are interhalogen compounds more reactive than halogens except fluorine? Because XX- bond in interhalogen compounds is weaker than XX bond in halogens, when we are not talking about fluorine-fluorine bond. These are the important compounds, interhalogen compounds, ClF3. T-shaped, IF7, pentagonal, bipyramidal, and these interhalogen compounds are used as non-aqueous solvents. Interhalogen compounds are very useful fluorinating agents. So students, this was all about the 17th group. Do the reactions in detail. Okay, thank you.